Inconveniences, there's technical issues.
Sure, no worries.
Sorry.
That's why That's why I was like, it's not like share yet. I don't believe what the government say. I was like, I'm sorry, I don't believe, because none of them are telling us the truth, and or they don't understand, I guess, you know, so at all, like, you know, so that's why I don't have managers and stuff, because nowadays it's then anymore. Like, it used to be, how, you know, a lot of things are 1 month with 1 euro.
Oh my god,
it's doable. I mean, like, okay, like, it was quite bad, like, at the time, because I was like waiting for my salary, and then I was like,
but it's doable, it's good already.
It's super high. I don't get when you're squeezing them. Trying.
My cousin also stay in Ireland. I also told my kids to go out and stay.
To go out. I was like, you know, like, I don't, honestly, you'll be shocked. I think Indonesia in this 5 to 10 years will go beyond us already.
They are
working. And now I can tell you, so many doctors, you know, they are pushing education like that, you know.
Yeah, they have a big, huge amount of money. They push for education, and
yes, very smart
universities.
You know,
they have a lot.
I was having a ASEAN talk. Oh my god, Indonesia. Oh my god, I was like surprised. Philippines also pushing math. Vietnam also math, but in educated, I was like, what? Some of them, because the guy wanted to control.
Yes, they want to control. You know? Yeah,
you faham kan? I mean, like,
I know.
I was like, I every day. Bila kawin.
Oh my god!
I was please lah. You know, the divorce rate is so high now. And also, people who push you to kawin is because they are from the industry of kawin, or the ustas and all stuff, because they're selling the, you know, the package. I know, because it's part of their rezeki and stuff. So I was like, the young one, like, didn't know, they just go, and then I was like, you sure or not? I keep asking a lot of them. I was like, please. I was like, it's very hard now.
Doctor, so, I think the team is ready.
All right, cool.
Finally, it's
no
worries. Okay.
Thank you, Doctor. Life right now. Sorry for causing trouble.
No worries.
Okay, it's still buffering. I think it takes some time for Zoom to.
Yeah, no worries.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, doctor, we will start at the beginning. Yeah, I'm sorry.
No worries. Yes.
A very good morning to our National Commissioner of Clover Guides, Dr. Noor Zafir Mat Saleh, honorable guest Dr. Su Winsi, and our audience that are watching live from YouTube, as well as those who are with me in this Zoom call. Welcome to our TED Talk session. I'm Noor Khalisa, your moderator for today. I hope everybody is in good shape and safe wherever you are. Widely spread this YouTube link around and join along. Don't forget to fill in the attendance form at the end of the session to be qualified for the certificate of this program. Okay, before we proceed with our TED Talk, the highlight of the Clover Carnivals 2021, I would like to introduce a little bit about our guest star today. She is very much well known as Malaysia's brand and beauty. Dr. Suwin Si is a multi-hybrid artist, academia researcher, producer, and beauty queen. Dr. Suwin Si has been awarded a number of prizes and honors from both locally and internationally, including her third time holding the national records, a Malaysian project to publish records set or broken by Malaysians. She was also selected as Berkeley Valencia Alumni Ambassador in 2020. Embrace all negativity and excel with positivity seems to be Dr. Suwin Si's motto in executing her vision with clarity. She once said that a good education is everything. If you are willing to work hard, success is guaranteed. Like the saying, teach a man to fish and he will have fish for his entire life. Thus, education and skill development play a major role in empowering women, as educated women can make well-informed decisions in life. I'm sure everyone is excited to know and learn more about our guest star. She will be giving her insights about women empowerment and share her life journey with us. By the way, we will be providing a Q&A form very soon if you have any questions. However, you can also send your questions through the live YouTube chat. So, without further ado, ladies, please join me in welcoming our guest, Dr. Suwin Si.
Hi. Hi, everyone. So, sorry for all the technical problem, but yeah, I'm very honored to be able to join you all for the talks today and stuff. So, I see like today, I think a lot of like girls around and then on the live chat as well, I'm checking here. So I was like, today, I think the topic is very suitable, especially women or girls nowadays, we have to step up our game. And also like, I'm proud, like, you know, to be one of the guests for the TED Talks today. So I'm going to share you all even more things so that, you know, you guys can ask any question, you know, any queries, especially like, you know, anything. So I'm going to share you all through my journeys and also a really genuine talk, you know, no sugar coating so that, you know, I guess I think everyone wants to know that what's behind the scene, you know. Whatever you saw, awards and stuff, that's just the icing, you know. But if the cake is not nice, the icing won't last. So my life, I as mentioned that I'm not being born, you know, because I just know how to complain or just give in to my own destiny. Again, that, you know, from a very Chinese background, you know, we are being... I'm surrounded by very traditional background where, you know, they just say that with my education or just get married is enough. But I guess I didn't want to be that Godzilla forever. So I decided to keep changing, you know. So back then as well, I don't speak English. Back then I speak Malay, but... You know, I was telling myself, how bad can it be? You know, I won't be that bad as a that Godzilla girl anymore. So I jumped from Chinese school to Malay school. And every time, whatever my decision is, I keep telling everyone, my only formula is, I don't want to stay comfortable. You know, never ever in my life, I will let myself to be comfortable because I know that, you know, if I want to achieve something, I must step up from my comfort zone. even I'm good or not good, I need to keep carrying on, you know. So life is not just about one day. It's not just about, you know, education as well. It's not just about one school or stuff. It's the whole journey. So I grow from there until then, slowly proceeding into more things, which is like what you saw, entertainment and all this. But I think just now the host, I was from a science background, but back then I have a music dream, but I don't dare to pursue. I only dare to do part-time. So I took a really, really long route, a very long journey, because back then we don't, you know, parents don't encourage us to get into our dreams and stuff. So for me, it took me a really way. But today I would really tell like the youngster to go ahead, you know, because nothing is much more scarier, or don't repeat my mistake, you know. Every generation, the importance of education as well. Senior, we always say that the good senior, we always go and test and error so that the junior can go ahead of us. So back then, in order for me to you know, to pursue my music dream and stuff, I need to do part-time music, but I need to do a full-time. I did like chemical engineering first, then I pivot to law, and then when I won Miss Malaysia, only I went the full blast to it. But I never gave up my education, because nothing, it's forever. So for me, ups and downs. So I keep going telling people that whatever you see is just the glam. Don't even be stuck on that. Don't even be blinded. You know, even exams or whatever, when you get the result, you have to keep going. If it's bad, polish. If it's good, continue, but you have to keep pushing. So I guess that spirit of I don't want to be gifted, I don't want to, you know, to just depend on all those things, that kept me until today. I'm still striving, you know, that kept me today, that I'm still that fluency. If I bump into my secondary schoolmate or my teachers, they would just see the same girl, but it's just that a more crazier version of me back then. So for me, like, you always know that where are you from, you know. We can go far, but the roots, you know. And I guess that today a lot of girls and stuff here, and then you all will go through a lot of transformation. And please, you know, don't even listen to people aside you. You have to defend your own journey, you know. When we go for a viva or examination, don't be shy, and don't be shy to fail, you know. Don't be shy of what people say about you, because nobody's going to live your dream, and we are going to take care of ourselves. We might not be as good as them, or, you know, whatever you do, people will say things. So I always tell them that sometimes just take an overall view, but defend what you want, be objective, be firm. And sometimes your failure or, you know, the journey is part of your whole journey. It's long route, you know. Don't go for the shortcut. Never, ever risk a shortcut for, you know, something, you know, is going to be longevity. But again, that there will always also be a time limit. Don't just stay there stuck forever. Sometimes I know that, especially nowadays, the COVID and all these things, people get down and people might just, you know, give up. But, you know, keep telling yourself that, you know, new things will form when the old things collapse. So I guess that now the whole COVID is just wiping away a lot of old formulas to blossom in the future. So don't be, you know, stuck on that, or don't be put down by people around you, you know, because it's a different generation stuff. And also that you girls and or any generation, so there is still a chance to change, you know. Again, that always, you know, now they keep going and protect what you want. And again, that know how to protect yourself, and also know how to choose. Because I guess like nowadays, we have to make a choice every single pathway or every single crossroad. you know. Sometimes it's okay to make a wrong choice and pivot it back. It's not wasted. It's always not wasted. Remember that, especially when you go to the education line. But always remember that, do not waste too much time on failure, on do not waste too much time on the negativity, you know. And when there is a negativity aside you and stuff, we try to embrace that. But the thing is, if you can't, you know, like, sometimes we also need to let go to go higher. So it's a long route. When I came to Spain as well, it was a very shocking, you know, kind of environment for me. And also a lot of things happened, even pre-COVID. I already experienced my own COVID 4 years ago when I came to Spain. And as mentioned, we keep telling the younger generation, go and explore the world when you still can, you know. Do not just listen to what I say and see it, touch it, and feel it, and experience the success yourself. We've been through all these things, you know. Every talk I'm not here, you know, I always like to share the failure stories. I always like to share human stories. I don't like to promote myself because I still think that I'm not doing my full best yet. And all, you know, I what we are doing now and all the education, it's not just us, you know. We can't excel if we are not in this game together. It's a sea of knowledge. It's a sea of people. You know, even we talk about technology, you need to work with intelligent people. You need to go and explore yourself. It's not just, you know, we alone, you know. We can't achieve all those things without our senior. We can't achieve all those things without our teams. A lot of things for us to do, the layered, you know, it's all symbiosis. So I always say that always your instinct, your intuition, especially as a girl, you can't lie. You always will ask yourself, is this right? If you feel that something is wrong, admit it, or if something is not feeling right, please go and check. You know, all those things is research, you know. It's all about, like, you know, it also, like, even everyone from the same course and stuff, when you come out, you might be doing something else, you know. The chances are not there yet. We do more and to wait for maybe bigger chance. Because sometimes every one of us, the timing is different, you know, and it's don't compare yourself. A lot of us here, we are all university students already. It's very different from back then to the school days, you know. Even the same project, but you come up with a different outcome, because a lot of things, it's not just MCQ already in this world. It's a lot of layering, a lot of subjectivity. So a lot of times that nowadays, everyone is unsure. But the thing is, like, when we are young, like, especially in our country, go and feel in our country first before you step up in overseas. Because in overseas, I told them, don't miss the step. It's just like learning dancing, learning piano and stuff. Try to do that. You don't lose it, or you don't lose so much money. Nowadays, like, we keep saying, like, you know, dare to go and start from low and then slowly climb your way up. Do not suddenly you start from up there and then you're going to fall. But, you know, a lot of us, we fell a lot of times, and the reality, there are still a gap. So always, you know, sometimes I know it's tiring, and for girls, we tend to be very emotional. It's good to be emotional, but sometimes you have to know how to let go of that, you know. Don't let anyone to affect your emotional as well. And I always tell them, show must go on. The journey must always go on. Things will always happen. Regardless of anything happen, your journey must always, always go on. You always must understand that. And no matter how bad it is, the things will get better as long as you keep going. If you are stuck there, you are forever stuck there. Things happen in life. So I keep telling the girls and stuff, you know, go and try, go and do, and go and show them that, you know, go and tell us that your thing is workable, your thing is doable. Because every one of us, we are the producer of our own life. We are the scientists of our own life, you know. To today, when I'm doing my second PhD, there's still so many questions. It's still, you know, I just read an article and stuff. It's they ask, there's so many doctors there. Do we still need so many doctors? Yes, we do. because the formula is changing every day. We need new doctors, new academic people, and new students to renew the sea, you know. You know, the sea, it's, there is a sea of pool of people, but we need new minds. We need new ideas. We need new batch of people because the time is changing. If we don't have this, we don't get sea. The sea will flow. So always tell you that, you know, a lot of people say that, you know, we're just saying like, you know, I saw a lot of like, although I'm in Spain, I keep seeing like, you know, they say that education is not important. And so I was like, no. You know, I was giving talks on international talks. And I saw, like, even Indonesia, there's so many doctors already. In Spain, even the guard is a degree holder. A lot of management artists, I need to get my double PhD. So when they keep telling us that it's not important and stuff, question them back. Because they are living in their own century. Or they are trying to control us so that we don't excel them. I always say that, you know, you know, even sometimes our parents might be wrong, you know. Sometimes, you know, I always say that be objective, you know. Why are they saying all these things? Why are we living into that social norm? Is the social norm going to fit you forever? It might work for last generation, but it might not work for your generation, you know. Even my batch of people, I argue with them. I was like, they were like, oh, why youngster? I was like, don't ever say that anymore. I was like, try and come down and see yourself. 10 years ago and 10 years now is different. If you check the policy in overseas as well, I was telling my mate, I was studying in UK. Do you know that currently they already don't allow entrepreneurship visa? They only allow innovation visa. Innovation visa meaning you have to have experience in tech world. You have to have education. They, meaning money can't buy any technology. And intellectual property is a next industry, which is industry 4.0. So I keep asking them and stuff, you know, outdated, change the future, you know, because when you do something outdated, we won't be as good as our senior, you know. The strategy is go into something in the future so that you live into the future, your fruition in the future. But again, that, you know, step by step, like it's a cycle of the game, you know. When we're young, our parents teach us, our senior teachers, but one day we might be teaching them back. It's a cycle of life, you know. Now I'm talking, but one day I might be listening to your talk. You know, there's no forever that, you know, I'm just up there and stuff. Those people who only me are the people who never go through the real life, or they went through everything by luck or by family, or, you know, always like ask, you know, things when you feel it, it's you can't fake it. So always tell yourself that, you know, keep challenging yourself. Like nowadays as well, they're looking for hybrid profile. They're looking for people who are adventurous because things are changing. That's not reading the catalog. Catalog is changing every day. For technology world, we are not just selling product. We're selling human beings. We're selling talents. We're selling services. So we're selling so many intellectual things here. You know, things are going to change, definitely. But we need to wait for that patiently. So do not get demotivated or don't give up. You know, a lot of times I keep asking myself, should I go back, but I say that, you know, whatever it is, at least we try our best to push forward, you know. And tell yourself that, you know, there are still younger people looking up on us, you know. Sometimes we need the push. Think bigger. If sometimes you don't get the energy from yourself, try and think bigger. Then, you know, there's a lot of goals still looking out on us. Even we fail, it's okay. You know, in the research as well, even we fail, at least we have a result for them. I was telling them, I respect people who dare to do, to dare to fail, rather than people who just talk and don't dare even dare to go and start the first step. So a lot of times you must know that, you know, if your surrounding are not giving you support and stuff, try and change your surrounding. Try and change it and try and, or, you know, try to leave that toxic environment and go into something which is more healthier for your mental health. And we are talking about gender equality as well. You know, at times, you know that you try your best, you know, always have a time limit as well, so you can move on to the next chapter of life. You know, it's just like studying. You can't just stop on one chapter, you know. You have to go, keep going. So I always tell them that, it's because of like we are keep chasing new things, then only we can keep on improving. If you think that you're good enough already, then you're just going to be stagnant, you know. Even your good, as long as we're still living, we always learn. As long as we are learning, we always give, you know. But we have to give to the right people, you know. We have to give in the right method, not just copy, not just like, you can reference, but always have your own ideas, you know. It's very strict in overseas, especially, like, they always say that don't, you have to be careful and stuff, but they always respect the human, you know, rights and stuff. So at times, you know, I always say that, you know, if things come too easily, please, please, please question if something is wrong, you know. Things, you need to work for it. That's the main thing, you know. That's real. Not just something where you are just enjoying it, like, so fast and stuff. That's very dangerous. It might be a scam. It might be something not right. Always ask, you know. If people who never feel also, there's something wrong. I always tell them that something is wrong, you know. We need to be human. We need to have a real story. We need to have authenticity. So always know this as well. It's not scripted. You have to go through all the life path. You have to go through all the exams. You have to go through all the path. Only that you are not afraid to speak up, you know. And only that you can speak up genuinely. You've been through that, you know. And also, you have your own story. And story is so, so, so important for your personal branding nowadays. Don't be afraid to fail, honestly. Because one day, you're going to advise people. You're going to tell them that this don't work because you've been through. You know, a lot of us as well. They can't listen to whatever the journey will show. You know, sometimes when the factual, there's no answer, the journey always reflect. So I always say that, you know, why the storytelling is so important, where, you know, Malaysian, they don't appreciate all those things. Storytelling is the only way which will last forever. You know, technology will keep improving, things will keep changing, but story lasts forever. Why history? Because it's your story which makes a difference, and all the stories combined, only we can change our time of history. You can't change a history with one person. So it's always that, you know, it's a bunch, it's a generation. So everything, you know, it's the hard contribution towards the whole thing. We will think, we are saying, like, you know, fighting for the equality, you know, the 17, like, you know, like, all the UN, like, fighting for zero poverty and all this. Yeah, like, and also fighting for quality education. We want to see that, you know, and the talent and the technology skill. Like, I was from performance. I came here to do tech stuff. You know, back then, I don't even have my technological skill. So I came and tell them that, you know, women equality is not just, you know, talking by the mouth. A lot of people, keep fighting, but they are not even practicing themselves. They are not even coming out to fight on the ground. That's not human, women equality. I always say that, you know, yourself as well, you know, it, they are not coming down, they are just talking on the surface. That's not women equality. Women nowadays, we do come down. We do go onto the battlefield. We do come down and fight for the right and to go into the mud with the men, you know. So for us to get here, we are not just fighting, you know. We have to prove it by our strength. Again, that we are not comparing with the men, because physicality and a lot of things, we are designed differently. So a lot of times, it's just like when I came here, I was working a lot with the men, you know, in the music production. I was the only girl. I was like feeling so slow. But I keep telling myself, because we girls have different way of learning stuff. Sometimes I told the men as well, I'm so sorry. Sometimes our way of doing stuff is very different from men. So a lot of time numbers into a very manly dominated world. I always tell them that, you know, even when you get married or anything, never ever give up on your career. Never ever give up on your own rights. Never ever give up on yourself, because things are shifting fast. You have no idea what will happen. And it's okay to get married later, or, you know, you want more firmer on your pathway first. Don't, whatever they tell you to do, you just go onto that, you know. And this quote, like, I want to share with you all, like, it's from Sun Tzu. The ultimate excellence lies not just in winning every battle, but in defeating the enemy without ever fighting. But in order to achieve the excellency, you need to be really equipped, and you need to have more things to give them so that you will win, you know. And again, that I always tell them that true heroes, what define us is how well we rise after we fall. You know, if you keep listening to people who always boast about themselves, that's not a winner. That's a loser, because they only know how to just only me. But you know, they are not the real winner. And the darkest night, I would say that will produce the brightest. You feel it's hard and stuff. It's just like exercise. If you feel hard, challenge yourself. You know, if now the time is hard, keep pushing yourself, challenge yourself. What else can you do, you know, to fight through the darkness? And then from there, you will gain it, because you're going to push your light. You're going to push your ultimate goal. You're going to push you even better than our seniors, that generation. So I always say that, you know, if we can't self now, there's no chance for us to complain. We go and do. We go and try. We go and seek whatever chances, even from low. You know, that's, you know, for me, I was like, ego is nothing. Put aside of ego. Let's come down together. Let's build. Everything is collapsed after COVID. So everything is changing. So come down and build your own things. When you come down, the first, the thing will belong to you. Those who don't dare to come down, or those who use fear, you know, and if you fear, sometimes ask why. They are planting fear on you, or, you know, why are you scared? You know, sometimes it's not you. People are planting fear for you so that they don't want you to excel. Always ask, you know. I always, like, you know, sometimes I did a lot of experiment and all those things. Like, when I feel fear and stuff, if it doesn't come from my side, someone else is implementing on me. So sometimes always ask yourself, you know, your own fear. If you're not good in this, try to conquer that, not to walk away first, you know. I always say that, you know, always get the best, the most, whatever you can. Nowadays, you have no idea. You can't just survive on one thing anymore. You can't just survive on a single thing. Future as well, in overseas as well, each of us have 3 to 4 jobs, so that there's no wastage. We don't wait for it, you know. So that's, we have backup, we have different things, so that if this one can't, plan A can't go, plan B, plan C, plan D, as long as you have things to sustain. If not, if just one is hard, a lot of people have went back. You know, things have changed. You have to up your game. You have to go through all those things. And we have nothing to, you know, to say and stuff. And sometimes, like, all these things, you get confused. It's normal, you know. It's normal to be betrayed. It's at a young age, go and fail to see the true faces around you, you know. It's saddening to say that we are living in a human world that, you know, is filled with a lot of negative things, because human beings, a lot of them, you know, they are born in that way where, you know, it seems good, but the thing is, like, they might not be the right people. Sometimes when you understand all this betrayers and all these things, then in the future, you know who to trust. You know who to choose. Sometimes it's not to say when you treat people good, they are going to treat us bad. You have to protect yourself, you know. Do not waste your time on something which is you can't change, you know. I always tell them, it's easier for us to change ourselves than to change others. I learned my lesson. I tried to change people. I was like, why not I change myself? And whether they can follow, can't follow, all due respect, that's their own choice. So I always say that you will go through all this confused route. You will go through a path where a lot of cross journey and stuff, but choose whatever is less travel so that, you know, it's not so congested. Always challenge yourself, you know, but it's always the same, you know, like the peak, you know, you'll always go to, you know, the end route, but with different ways. So when you feel confused, unsure and all this, experience it now when you can, when you are in 2 years. Do not waste time when you come up in the work field, because that will cost you more. That will be even unsure. So sometimes when you're in the school time and stuff, dare to go and challenge, get there to go and feel, dare to go and see more, so that you understand and acknowledge the feeling of the stuff you go, so that whenever that feeling trigger you, it's going to be a warning for you, you know. When you experience all those things as well, like you have to draw your own path, you know. And always remember, old method, it won't guide you in the new world. You have to do it new way. But again, the new way, you have to reference from established theory, established things. You can't create a new way without a references from the previous example. So always have a balance, you know. again, that you see the graph, like, there is a stagnance. It's the same thing as, like, when we want to go on diet and stuff, you know, because sometimes when you're stagnant and stuff, it might be because it's going to prep you to leverage to the next level. So no matter how many times you try and stuff, you have to keep trying, have to keep going. You must do until that, you know, you da takisada, you know, it's like when you feel, I've done it, then actually the success will come, you know. If you're still not trying hard and you're not trying enough, the thing won't come, you know. They always say that, you know, oh, you're given and you're all this thing. If you're given but you're not polishing it, it won't work, you know. Here as well, I met a lot of great musicians and great people. They told me the same. We have a 10,000 hour rules. If you don't, every skill to achieve mastery level, you have to at least practice 10,000 hours, you know, in order to achieve mastery level. So that's how the international, like Harvard or Berkeley, that's how they time us as well. Every day we are pushed into 20 hours of practice. We are pushed into all this in order to get into the excellency and stuff. If after school, you have to go on yourself. So always know that school is just for you to get the formula. After that, you have to go beyond that. You know, it's not just that we are feeding you, we are spoon feeding you, but you have to get that and do even better than us. You know, draw your own path. Keep on going that, you know, everything's the same, you know, it's tuition, everything's the same, but why, you know, what differentiate and all this? It's just the hourly spent and it's just the push. It's just the all the little bits. It's not about money or whatever. No. Money can't buy intelligence. Trust me, our money is very small if you come out and see the world. You know, people in overseas, they want intellectual people. And go and explore, go and Google and online, go and step away, you know, challenge yourself to apply for scholarship. There's so many scholarships out there, you know, if they're not promoting it in local and stuff, go and seek online, go and ask, you know, go and see it yourself. Don't only listen, you know, because things you listen, they are just sales, they are just marketing, you know, even in education as well. Go and see yourself. And then go and, if you want to go overseas, go and your way, how budget and sleep. Actually, when you are not going through a middleman and stuff, and students are so smart nowadays, go and seek your ways out and go and try and grow until you make it. You know, if you can't, go and design a new path, go and design your ways. Each of us, we can share the formula, but each of us are human beings. You have your own formula to succeed. You know, even like I give the same ingredient to different people, it's going to taste different, you know. So always remember that. I know that a lot of people are educated, but, you know, we are fighting for the equality. As educated, then we don't need so much, you know, unnecessary politics. Or we can govern our own life even better than anyone else. So that's why in order for the whole world to advance, we have to have more educated people. We have to have more successful examples. We have to have that thing to fight for the next wave, you know, in order for us to advance together. Because if not, it's going to create a lot of social problem as well. So a lot of times, you know, like this one as well, a strategy where I always set a KPI. KPI is a key performance index, like, and then, you know, always guided by the objective, mission, the most important, your values. You know, we can have a lot of great objective, the mission, vision, but if your values, you don't have the values, you know, values is like things where, you know, people takisa, you know, never appreciate. But that value, it's your, you know, it's like your compass. You know, you have to put in like integrity or, you know, values of a lot of humble or things. It's just like spices. The small little spices, it's going to make a huge difference in your dish. So, you know, one dash of salt will change the whole taste of your whole plate of food. So I always say that don't just look at the big chunk of things, you know. Always know that, you know, it must be achievable, like SMART and all these things, which is very objective. Do not go into something where, and nowadays we're all educated and stuff. Do not believe that, oh yeah, I feel this. And yeah, when you feel it and stuff, it can be researched. It can be broken down. It can be doable. You know, always go through that path where structure it down, break it down, how to achieve that things, but always guided with the value proposition. Where, you know, what's your purpose in life? why are you doing that? You know, I'm sure that a lot of you will achieve your goal. But I don't want you all, when you reach out there, you feel empty, you know, or you achieve your goal in the wrong direction. So a lot of like my batch of people, they only like rush for the KPI objective, but they lost out the purpose. They lost out their value when they, and a lot of them have to redo the whole thing. So when you're young and stuff, always ask, what's your value? You know, so that one day, like 4 years ago, I really gave up all my career back home. I came down as a crew. I went and do music production. That decision was guided by my own purpose and value, because I told myself that I need to have my own purpose. You know, if I felt that, you know, I'm not learning anymore and I lost my direction, I will come down again to build up new things. So back when I was facing with a lot of huge thing to make, that value proposition guided me until today. And so that, you know, even I don't know the result, but the value will always lead you towards good goals, good choices. And that thing as well will detox you from a lot of toxic environment. So it really guided me until today, where do not just ignore the value proposition, where you must know that that thing is going to make you different from others in the future. That thing, you're going to gain your respect, you know, it's beyond just result. Respect is something where it's hard to earn, you know, it's going to be a really long road, a really hard work, dedication, and still you are not losing yourself. So sometimes we girls, you know, we have big heart. But I always tell girls, remember, don't lose focus, okay? We are good, we can hybrid. I always tell that guys is very straight, but girls, we have things where we love to do a lot of things, because mom, you know, look at mother, they can do a lot of things, have to focus as well. So always, like, you know, you have to know that, you know, how much can you give? If it's okay, like, you can take a break, and also that, you know, you don't need to give all, like, you give whatever you have, or you can focus back on yourself. Don't lose yourself. Always. Even you do your research and always things, like, I always say that if you don't know how to take care of yourself, it's hard to take care of others. So if you want to save people as well, you should be safe before to save people, not jump into the fire and die together. You know, I always tell them that don't do something which is, you know, just because of you never think or something where people push you into it. But always know that, you know, pull back and protect back, you know. Even you're being teased or whatever, it's okay, you know. Genius are always like, you know, I always tell them that extraordinary people will do extraordinary things. I always say that if people are talking about you, meaning you're attracting their attention, and do whatever you think is right for you. You know, sometimes it comes in various ways. We are human beings. There's no one formula, you know. It's not just follow one rules. That's not the way nowadays. And people who are educated, and each of you all have your own story, will have your own, remember, gender equality, to fight for all these things, we have to build step by step. You have to set your own KPI. You have to set your own objective, your own mission, vision, all this even combined together, and combined with our background, combined with everything, is going to make each of us think and will guide you into your dream jobs, into your dream business, or into your dream journey in the future. But that whole thing, this whole pyramid, it's what is going to stack up. So always ask yourself now, you know, and it must be achievable. And, you know, be specific as well. And every day, sometimes I even check back, you know, like sometimes I'm even more extreme. I have yearly KPI, monthly KPI, and I have daily KPI, and sometimes I have hour KPI. So I always tell them that, you know, protect your dreams until it become true. Work hard for it until it become true. Sometimes we don't talk too much. We show them by our results. You know, that's the way to protect your dream as well. sometimes it's okay to keep it yourself. You don't need to share everything to others because that's your own rights, you know. Nowadays, I know that, you know, I always say that I used to think, hey, why people are not sharing? But I was thinking like, because I think nowadays it's dangerous to share everything as well, you know. You have no idea. People will steal your ideas and stuff. So nowadays, I would say that it's a balance, you know. Know how to share to the right people and know how to keep away from the wrong people. You have to choose because this world, there's a lot of people where it's okay. You know, like I always say that, you know, girls, I've been through this mistake where I sympathize and, you know, others, but we are going into the war. If you sympathize, you bring in the wrong people, it's going to kill your whole team. So sometimes we have to be objective professional and bring in the right people and not the wrong people. Don't fail on the sympathize. We can empathize, but not sympathize, you know. And we have to be objective. Think a further view, you know. It's not just bringing the wrong people, but the whole team lost, or it's going to damage the whole thing. That's going to cost you more. That's even going to, the cost of sympathy is going to be even greater. So always know that, have a balance of that, but be objective and try, you know, we are living, you know, society where it's still a lot of part of it, but know how to avoid a lot of things without, you know, without getting into trouble. And as well as we respect, but we also respect our own decision. So sometimes be smart, be flexible, but try and be, you know, be firm as well. So the balance is hard, but find your own balance, find your own ways, because that's going to train you in the workforce in the future. But always remember, don't just work for something blindly. And each time, every hurdles will come, but you have to fight it. Each of girls, you got all of us, are the superhero of our life, you know. Guys or girls, nowadays is all equal, you know. One thing, go and don't let the old mindset confine you. If you don't seek chances, head out. Keep heading out. Go and explore the world. Sometimes it's not your fault. You know, it might be a lot of things happening and stuff, but always know that. Find ways, you know, always find ways so that one day, I always say that people who go through the toughest journey is going to excel. It's going to excel, definitely. If you read about the legend, people who succeed, each of them have amazing story to show. Those who have no story to show are just scammers or people who are trying to sell you things, you know. So don't worry about the age as well. You know, age is just a number. Even you're young, you're not working hard, or you're old, you're working hard. It comes still into your essence. It comes to your journey. How long can you sustain? You know, it's easy to succeed fast nowadays, but it's hard to succeed step by step with the right way. So do not ever take shortcut. I always say that go the longer route. Go the longer route. Enjoy all the journey. Enjoy all the views, you know, so that you also can meet the right people and you can learn with the best. So it's always, you know, when people will say that, oh, you know, why are we so stubborn or you know, in kata Melayu, pentingkan diri, actually it's not, it's just defending what you want, you know. Even leave onto their opinion and stuff, they are going to say us as well. So in this world, there's a lot of people will talk about anything. As long as you think that your journey suits you and stuff, go for it, you know. As long as it's the right way and stuff, go for it, you know. If we keep on living under the shadow of people, under the comments of people, we're in a lot of direction, we're going to fail. Or even if we succeed living people's comment, that's going to be very painful. So, but also, like, you know, push it in a good way sometimes. But again that each of you, you know, grow your dreams, like, so that one day every one of you will be the superhero of your own life, you know. So that, you know, girls today, we are stronger than we can imagine. It's just that we haven't pushed our potential into that limit. So that's why I keep saying, go for it. So that independent, one day you're going to have freedom of your own. Freedom, it's beyond monetary value. Your mind, your soul, your creativity, your success, you know. Go limit yourself nowadays. I would say that don't limit yourself. Don't just like that. Always go out and see and challenge yourself step by step, so that you know that, you know, and you keep on taking action. You have to take action. If you don't take action and stuff, it's not going to work. Even nowadays, technology have made life easier. You can take action online. You can go and search and learn online free lessons. There's a lot of free lessons online. Go and Google. And then there's a lot of things we can share among each other and stuff, so that, you know, we are helping each other, you know. So information and stuff, keep sharing, keep going, and keep on taking action every single day. And sometimes when you're tired, it's okay. You know, take a break one day, then push again. It's a long way. I can tell you that we are human beings. I can't tell you that I'm motivated every day, but we try to be grateful of all the small little things, so that it's going to take more action and more bigger things are coming. So sometimes action, it doesn't mean that a huge action. So you can take baby steps, then slowly you form something big. So a lot of things, do it on your own way, do it in your generation, and reinvent yourself. Keep reinventing yourself. When you keep doing that, new waves or new things will become true, and dreams will come reality when the action is taken. And even that's failure and stuff, one day you're going to share your stories. One day you're going to inspire more people, because a lot of, like me, I get old one day, you know, everyone have their own time frame. A lot of things where go and see and listen to more people's real stories, that will bring you a longer route and focus back on what you want. It's always doable. It's always doable and always on. I think that today, like, I'm honored to share like all the stories and all the journey I've been through as well. But again, that I hope that, you know, this will encourage you to go through time now. Slowly, I think that later on, more things are changing. The world is changing after COVID, but we still need to keep pushing. Things will be reinvented, and try and challenge yourself to go in a newer way, but don't give up. Always don't give up. You know, no matter what, always stand up again and go again. No matter how many times you fall, remember that, you know, you fall and stuff, there's still a Godzilla girl here who keep failing and still sustaining, trying my best to push in front. You know, sometimes even no support, I need to go, but that lonely path will train you up as a very brave person in the future. So a lot of us, you know, we are going through that path, I guess, like, you know, girls, a lot of us are going through that path now, but in the future, you're going to see really tough girls, really, really intelligent people. And really, I really wanted to see the journey, every single sectors, every single industry. We need to push it forward. We need to see more goals, we need equality, we need to have zero poverty. That's our dream, you know. It doesn't mean, you know, what for having so much money where your social security is not good, everything is not good. That will be just a waste of our democracy. That would just be a waste of education. So Industry 4.0, which is a high intellectual, high tech world, is coming. So always remember. And sometimes it's good to go and make friends with overseas people, so that go and see and yourself without listening just the news, without just listening just what I told you. Experience yourself, see it yourself. The proof is by yourself. And studying as well, go through that path, and then whatever people say, don't care, as long as you know what you want to do. you know, don't fall into the other's trap, you know. Sometimes I would say that don't feed the attention of the bad person and don't let the bad person win, you know. Let the genuine person win. Let your genuine dream flourish. Let yourself, you know, go beyond all fears, go beyond all odds and achieve more possibilities, you know. Nothing is like gifted. Nothing is like, you know, by hierarchy and all these things. The real person know that, you know, if you do the most, you work the hardest, it's going to come. It's going to be, that's the most genuine one. And you can't lie. You can't judge from the speech of the people. You can judge from the every single thing, you know. Always question, you know. Sometimes I encourage students to ask, don't just, you know, accept. You know, I might be wrong, you know, but it's like 360 way. We learn together. We learn together, we so that, you know, it's all 360 way so that we give the right thing. So, yeah, thank you so much for inviting. And I really hope that the talk today is going to inspire you to take action on your own route. And if I'm not stopping, please don't stop, you know. And if you have any question and stuff, I'm going to answer. And always, you know, I always say that if you feel scared and stuff, someone and ear, always can PM me online. I always answer, especially to students, girls, and, you know, I'll give you a very honest opinion and stuff. We also like helping students to more things and stuff. So, yeah, I think that actually that was my dream, like, since young. I really, like, you know, one of my dreams is to help a lot of students, especially Malaysian students. Because I've been through all these things, and I know that it's a tough route, but we need a lot of people to get through all these things. But it's going to be good, yeah. It's going to be great, and as long as we keep going and just keep on pushing to the new world, yeah.
What an insightful speech given by Dr. Suwinsi. Before we proceed, let me highlight some crucial points that I got from this session. There's more, but I will make it short. So the first one is try and error in everything you do. From there, you will know which part need to be improved. Next, you have to define your own journey, like, because you are your own limit. And lastly, life is short. Don't waste it with negative people who don't appreciate you. Just keep them in your heart, but keep them out of your life. Okay. Remember, at the end, we will have a photo session, so please open up. I'm sure that our audience is very delighted listening to this talk and has learned a lot from it. I hope Dr. Suwinsi is also having a great time with us while sharing her experience. Without wasting time, let's move on to the Q&A session asked from the audience. Are you ready, Doctor?
Yes.
Okay. So the first question is, how should we stand up for women's rights?
All right. I think this one is this question is it's very good because I guess a lot of people that, you know, people think that, you know, just by quarreling is standing up for women's rights and all those things. But in order for us to stand up and as a woman and all this thing, is go down again to prove it to themselves and to also show them by the process, you know. But again, that lead by example, that will be the greatest thing. Yeah, lead by example is something where, you know, nowadays people, when people like to copy and stuff, you know, because talking about if sometimes we're just talking but we're not doing, not leading by example, it won't work. So always we talk about you know, like women equality and stand up for women rights. We are not from like Western country where, you know, riots and all this thing, it might not work. You know, I always say that the strategy used in Western country is very different from Asian country. We have to be smart in all this. If you try to voice up too much and stuff, and but you're not doing all the stuff, people will think that you are just talking very surfacely, or you are seen as a bad person. So don't waste your energy in losing yourself in all this. So lead by example and do it, you know, when again, that your qualification or your tech skill or things where, you know, the guys can do, the women can do it as well, you know. So always that, you know, standing up for women's rights is always leading by example, rather than just, you know, speaking out blindly, because there are still deep sea of things we need to learn from the guys, because physically they are way ahead of us, and they are still physically, you know, are gifted that way. So for us girls, we need to humble ourselves as well, you know. I don't like people where you're fighting for women's right, but you're stepping on the guys, or you're using on us, or we are complaining. So for us, if we want to fight the equality and stuff, it's not comparison at all, but it's to work the best and to accommodate our best so that we're not fighting against the guys. You know, guys are meant to be something, girls are meant to be something. You know, we can't be always, you know, if you want to fight physically, it's hard, you know, and you know, a lot of things were designed differently. So in order that is to lead by example, be humble, and know how to strategize and know how to position.
Okay. Yes, Dr. Suwinsi has wisely put her words, which is lead by example. We all are designed with our own dreams and points of view. I know it's starting to be our favorite line. Women are no longer viewed in the light of that women should do, and are instead seen for who they are, because everyone has their own needs and desires. Okay, let's proceed with the next question. I'm pretty sure many of us here are eager to know what inspires you to further your education despite already being in a comfortable place.
Well, the main reason which inspire me, I guess I would say it's the next generation. Because when I gotten everything, but when I came down, I saw like how intense you all are learning, and how great, like, you know, I can learn from you all. That's why when I came down again, I learned from the young people. You know, I have friends where, you know, are born young and stuff. So I felt that rush of things where, you know, things are changing every day. I'm learning from you all as well, you know. If 10 years ago, I might be saying that maybe I'm learning from my senior, but now I felt I learned more from the young people, from my younger fans. And I understand that you all, your brains, and you all are like way smarter than a lot of us, a lot of our batches. So when I came out, what inspired me is really, it's you all, you know. I was like, you know, as mentioned just now, things are 360. When you give, things will come back. So I remember like 4 years ago, I was stuck in my career. I was given a lot of things. I was given a lot of jobs, but in the sake of, I felt empty in my heart and in my brain. So if I felt that, I told myself it's not enough already. So I decided to come down and reinvent. And thank God I came. So I gotten my offer in overseas. And then only I saw that, you know, the nation is very different already, and whatever I learned before, I need to relearn or reinvent. So I guess that I would also like to, you know, for me, I would say that I won't stop until I will win some international award back for Malaysia. So that was always my dream. Yeah.
Well, that's very inspiring. Things were tough initially, and I'm sure we need to put a huge effort into what we are striving for. Next. Doctor, seems like we are getting close to the end of our time together. Any last word from you, Doctor?
My last word is always remember that we are all in this together, and don't be afraid. We are not competitor at all. And we're going to take our turns to go up. It's just like climbing up the mountain. Each of us will reach the peak and we'll share. So keep striving, keep going, no matter how hard it is, how negative it is. Go and strive harder, you know, go and do better, you know, go and do not repeat our mistake. Go and do better than us, you know. That's the point of education. And we're going to fight for equality in a tremendous way. I'm going to take more time, but the bridge can't stop. So I always say that keep going and make us all proud, you know, so that one day I'm going to listen to your story. One day when I'm old and stuff. So that's really my dream, you know. For me, I don't like to be always just up there. I would like to come down and serve more. And that's my point, you know. That's succeed. Seeing you all doing wonders. We as a senior, we are just the first person, you know. We are just a starter to open up the door so that you all can go beyond us. So that's really, really my dreams and advices for a lot of girls out there. And the second thing is like, push as hard as you can. You know, when people say no, please go or full force onto your ability. You know, you all are way smarter. And remember that the sky is the limit.
I really love how badly you encourage us to see the world and chase your art. Can I ask for one more question?
Yes.
Thank you. So, next question is kind of short and simple, mm-hmm. but there is a deep meaning behind it.
Yeah.
Doctor, mm-hmm. how do you stay motivated?
Okay. I think this question, I always admit to my own demotivated first, because you have to acknowledge your down point first. I always say that don't be ridiculous and admit that you're motivated all the while, because that will become toxic positivity. You know, always admit that what happened or where always acknowledge where did the negativity come, so that you acknowledge what's the causation of that, so we can know how to rectify it. So for me, in order for me to feel motivated, I need to admit that what makes me not motivated first, so that one I can solve it. And the second thing is like go and have new hobbies, go and do something beyond just what you're doing, because sometimes we might be stuck on one path and we can't. When you add on something else from the other path, you're going to learn something where it's going to teach you back on whatever you failed before. So for me, to stay motivated as well, I divert my attention to some other stuff like music or new hobbies or something else. You know, if you stop and stuff, you want to get motivated sometime, go and seek your own, you know, from your hobbies or other tunnels, that's going to motivate you. Or sometimes even I go and watch some free YouTube videos and stuff, because sometimes rather than I'm stuck and stuff, I want to go and listen to, you know, what people have been through. If people can survive that, that's going to motivate me. And sometimes as well, another thing to motivate me is like I like to chat with my fans online, and a lot of young people will come and ask me questions and stuff, so that keep me going as well. Because again, that we admit that there's a problem, but we know that we have to keep on striving. So sometimes you must know that, especially in overseas, there's no guarantee for me. And every single year, my visa might be rejected. I might lose my chance in overseas every single year. And I'm sitting exam every year to survive and to get my visa. So, and I'm alone. So, to stay motivated alone, it's hard. But technology nowadays plays a huge role. So try and use various way and cheaper way as well, so that you can budget. So, and you can't move so much. So try to make use of whatever to stay positive and as well as keep moving forward.
That's another tips from the amazing Dr. Suin Sis, everyone. We tend to get demotivated at times, which makes it harder for us to focus on our goals. But as what has been said by our guest earlier, we need to push ourselves. We need to push ourselves. That really stores a heavy motivation for all of us here. Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Doctor, for answering the question. Q&A session. Before we go on to the photo session, you have 2 minutes to fill in the attendance form in order to receive your certificate for this program. Those who are watching live right now, the link also provided in the chat box. You could get clenched. I'ma come out on the top. I can run all the odds against me. I will. You can see it in the way we walk. You can hear it in the way we talk. There ain't anything we can't do. There ain't anything we can't do. They'll believe it when you stand inside. Okay, let's take a group picture. Please open your cameras. Wow. Beautiful girls.
Hey everyone, 1, 2, 3, smile. One more time, 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, done.
Carnival 2021. We will be taking a short break for 20 minutes. Please be right back before 11:25 for our closing ceremony. Thank you and stay safe, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. All the best.
What time is it?
It's 5 o'clock. I'm going saho already.
That's so cool. I managed to look so good at 5 a.m. while we're all just here.
No, I was like, I'm going to Saho and then I'm going to sleep already. I was like, I came back from a shoot just now, so I haven't rested for the whole day yet.
Oh my god.
I haven't slept at all. First day I quickly push myself and sleep. My schedule is a bit crazy sometimes, yeah. So I sometimes my timing is like jumble up already sometimes here. So so sometimes I push and then I was like, and later on I'm going to sleep like mad or anything.
Yeah. Do you like spend time to like for like self-care to go to spa or something? Because you still like keep your appearance.
No, honestly, no. I honestly in Spain it's hard to do that and COVID and for me I need to budget and a lot of things. So I never go for spa whatever here. Here you want to go out as well, it's expensive here. I mean like stay is cheap, but sometimes you want to spend on luxury things. I don't want to spend unnecessary things. So sometimes for me it's like I always say that less is more. Less is more. If nothing to do, I just go and sleep or you know, something where everything I can detox. That's why I like puasa. It's like detox. I love it. I always puasa. I was like, it's like if I felt honestly, I can tell you that. If you want to look young, right, no need. Just puasa. I was like, that's going to keep you so young. I was like, for me, I was like, honestly, right, I'm not just fasting on puasa day. If I feel very tired and stuff, right, spa can't work. For me, I was like, I just don't eat and I just maybe puasa papa jauh, go and sleep.
Yeah. doubted yourself. Matter of fact, you should be proud of yourself, because you had to find a way, go about it yourself. Nobody gave you the rest, you had to ride it yourself. And you never got lost, losing not an option. No time for L, no time to fail. Winning like Steph Curry and them, we warriors. Haters want to see me in a crown, Victoria. But I'm in the Benz, AC on chest, not checkers. Playing it with strategy, me and Jessica, that's a win on the map.
Okay, dengar tak? Dengar?
Dah clear dah.
Jelas? Dah clear dah? Okay, I dah tukar setting.
Thank you.
Test, test, test. Okay tak?
another life. We're not gonna straddle the crisis. We can't.
Assalamualaikum all. I kan ada the slide tau nak share.
kawin ang
My body is a relic of an untrained ballerina. Quit at 5, you should have seen her, she was great. Scared off by talents and buns who could balance an art with an impossible weight. Waste all my money on books that I won't read. Still stories look pretty on my dusty shelf. And I keep shit talking the girls I respect, cause I'm not far away from who I was at 12. I'm a mess in a dress, just short of a college degree.
All right. Welcome, everyone, to the closing ceremony of Clover Carnival 2021. I'm Nadia, your MC for today. Throughout this week, many of you have completed the activities we have organized and gained a lot of insights on women empowerment. Please give yourself a big round of applause for your hard work. Sadly, all good things must come to an end. But fret not, Clover Guides Malaysia will come up with something more exciting in the future, and make sure to keep yourself updated by following our socials. All right, to start off our closing ceremony today, I would like to invite Nik Nur Shamimi Auni binti Muhammad Nazri, the Deputy Director of the Clover Carnival 2021, to say a word or two.
Okay, thank you, Noreen. Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to the National Commissioner of Clover Guides, Dr. Nur Zafir Mat Saleh, all the committee members of Clover Carnival 2021, and the fellow audience who are watching us from the YouTube live. First and foremost, I would like to congratulate all the committee members who have been working together for the past few months just to make this carnival come true. As we all know, this is the very first program that was organized by Clover Guides in collaboration with 5 universities, which are UPM, UTHM, UTM, UM, and also UNM. Collaboration would not be possible without your participation and commitment. I would say it wasn't an easy journey, but we all managed to put in our greatest efforts and willing to sacrifice our time, despite the fact that we can't all meet in person, but meeting and working with all of you virtually had been truly amazing. Not to forget to our National Commissioner of Clover Guides, Dr. Norzafe MD Saleh, who has been helping us and guiding us throughout this program. Next, I would like to thank all the participants who involved in this Clover Carnival program, and congratulations to those who have completed 5-day digital challenges. I hope that the awareness that is created on the importance of loving yourself as a woman and daring to speak up will be useful for us, so we can raise awareness of women's rights together and inspire one another. We also encourage all of you to cultivate the woman empowerment spirit. To end my speech, again, I would like to thank everybody who has devoted their efforts to ensure this event runs. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you, Nur Shamimi, for the lovely speech. Next, I would like to call upon Dr. Nur Zafir Mat Saleh, the National Commissioner of Clover Guides, to deliver her speech. Miss, I think you're muted.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much. Thank you, MC. MC today is, for this session is, siapa ya?
Nadia.
Nadia, I'm so sorry, Nadia. Okay, Nadia, thank you very much, Nadia. Okay, first of all, I would like to say thank you to all the Clover Carnival Committee, ESCO members, yeah? Because without you, we can't have this program, definitely. You have created a very powerful keyword or hashtag, woman moment, and also woman empowerment, and also a digital challenge pack, activity pack. Those are the things that you have created. Actually, you are the pioneer who's doing Clover Carnival to the Clover activities. You are the pioneer, you are the one who paved the path for Clover Girl Guides, okay, activities, yeah. So earlier a week ago, we have our opening ceremony by Dato' KP, Dato' Jaya, and also the following, throughout this week, we have digital challenge. So we did have a mini now with Dr. Su Win Chi. It's not easy to get her to commit to our program, but alhamdulillah, we got it. And her talk is so motivational. And I hope all of you take advantage or take good points from her. And now 1 week program couldn't be happening if Clover Carnival Exco committee did not start it. I still remember that we have a small discussion, Aina, late last year, October last year. And finally, we got to do this program April. Okay, so, we need to accept that along the way, we don't always make the right decision. Sometimes it will screw up big time, but understand that failure is not the opposite of success. It is part of success. So our level. So we have to push ourselves. And with this program, this kind of program and a future program, being able to participate in this, in Girl Guide program, you are pushing yourself to the next level. So you have to congratulate yourself if you finish the activity pack. Even though if you don't finish it, you still have to congratulate yourself because you have tried it. Okay, so remember, you also have role to play, okay, in the community. Being a student or being a leader in a small group, being a leader in your family, you have a role to play. Okay, probably you can share my slide, Aida. All right, slide saya highlight two important quotes for women and leadership. But while waiting for the slides, let me continue with my speech. So, especially to the new leaders of Clovers, yeah, Clovers, Majlis Clover yang kita akan lantik sekejap lagi. I really hope that you could follow good examples of your seniors. That I think has been grown. Your skills, your values as a leader has been grown from being a girl guide since you were small. If you were a girl guide, if you are not, then this is the time for you to take advantage of girl guide program and keep growing, okay? All right, can you make it? Yeah. I would like to share with you these two quotes. It's from popular quotes, okay? Do not follow where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path. And leave a trail. This is what definitely you are doing. The current Clover Carnival Exco and committee. Yeah, so we don't have a path yet, but we have to create the path. So we are definitely going to leave a trail. Okay, next. And please remember that you are never too small to make a difference. Okay, if you think that you are nobody, you have no skill, you have like different or difficulty to talk, for example, some people do not have confidence to talk. You are never too small to make a difference. You can grow yourself, just like Dr. Suwinchi said. You have to spend more time to improve yourself and make a difference, okay? So with that, saya akhiri dengan lafaz bismillah. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, saya dengan ini menutup Clover Carnival tahun ini. Sekian, terima kasih. Back to you, MC Nadia.
All right. Thank you so much. What a powerful speech given by Dr. Zafir. I'm positive that all of us are inspired to be a great leader one day and make the world a better place. Now, the moment we've all been waiting for, it's time for us to get to know the backbones of Clover Carnival from this video prepared by the multimedia and publicity team. Okay, thank you to all committee members for making this event a success by working together virtually for the past few months. It was not an easy journey, but with hard work and dedication, anything is possible. Next, here comes a video that compiles snippets of activities throughout the whole week of Clover Carnival 2021. I will now pass on to the technical team to play the montage video.
On this note, I hereby officially launch the opening of the Clovis Carnival 2021. Thank you very much.
This year's theme is hashtag Women Moment, highlighting the power and effort of us empowering women all around the world, including ourselves. We hope that this can be an annual event for future Clovers to connect with each other while fulfilling the pillars of this program.
Confidence, yes. Confidence is really important. That. Nandre, Shukran, Grata, Arigato, hi. Thank you so much, everyone.
Shapes the destiny of civilization. Such is the tragic irony of fate.
I tried to change my life because I thought.
Right inside of you. Don't hold back and don't hesitate. Second, take action. Get out of your comfort zone and dive into a more challenging one. Overcome your fears, take the challenge, and this is how you are able to build your own self-efficacy and self-confidence. The last one is to let go of the need to be perfect. We do not live in this world to meet other people's expectations. What other people say about us does not matter. But instead, we need to determine our own values and who we are on the inside. Alright ladies, it is time for us to prove that we are also competent. We have the ability, capability, and potential to rise high and achieve our own success. Best of luck.
Dr. Su Win Si.
Hi.
Hi, everyone. So, sorry for all the technical problem, but yeah, I'm very honored to be able to join you all for the talks today and stuff. So, I see like today, I think a lot of like girls around and then on the live chat as well, checking here. So I was like, today, I think the topic is very suitable, especially women or girls nowadays, we have to step up our game. And also, like, I'm proud, like, you know, to be one of the guests for the TED Talks today. So I'm going to share you all even more things so that, you know, you guys can...
Things will keep trending, but story lasts forever. Why history? Because it's your story which makes a difference, and all the stories combined, only we can change our time of history. You can't change a history with one person. So it's always that, you know, it's a bunch, it's a generation. So everything, you know, it's the hard work contribution towards the whole thing.
Did you have fun, girls? I bet you have. Thank you, everyone, for taking part in our activities. We are really grateful for your participation in our carnival this year. And I hope those activities bring out the best version of yourself and enhance your leadership skills you did not know you had. Ladies, we are close to the end of the program. On behalf of the Clover Carnival Committee, I, Nadia, your MC for today, would like to thank each and every one of you for giving your full commitment and dedication throughout this carnival. I would like to apologize for any flaws or imperfection on our part. Now it's time for a photo session. So everyone, please open your camera and smile. Can we have someone to count the photo session?
Yeah, sure. Okay, everyone ready?
Ready.
1, 2, 3, smile. Another 1, 1, 2, 3, smile.
All right, thank you. Congratulations to those who have completed the digital activity pack, and we would like for you to fill in the feedback form provided in the slide to improve more in the future, and feel free to provide us with suggestions for our upcoming event. Before we end, let's sing along to one of the Girl Guide songs called Ram Sam Sam. Come and join and sing along with me, guys. We will give you 2 minutes to fill in the feedback form first. Okay. Before we end, let's all sing along to one of the Girl Guides song called Ram Sam Sam. Come and sing along with me, guys. It's an interesting song. All right. Thank you guys for singing along. I'm so sorry for the technical difficulties just now. I got kicked out from the call. And with that, our carnival ends here. Thank you and see you guys soon. And don't forget to make this your hashtag woman moment. Thank you guys. Have a great day. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you, Esco. I don't know how can I